Welcome to this week's video. We are today going to take you on a tour of five or six New Forest beaches that are situated in and around the coast in Hampshire. We are going to go to Barton-on-Sea, Milford-on-Sea, and then over to Hurst and Keyhaven, up to Leap, a little bit further to Calshot, and finally ending up in Elling, and this is the route we are going to take. So please join us on our adventure around the New Forest beaches today. Hello, hello. We are getting ready today to go to five different beaches around the New Forest. We have Leap. Now let's start. We have Barton-on-Sea, Milford-on-Sea, Keyhaven, Leap, Calshot, and Elling. But we're not sure about Elling, so it could be six beaches. And let's go. And I've just noticed that the van in front has National written on it, which I'm pretty sure has nothing to do with the National Motor Museum, which Bewley is famous for. So you have to be very careful when you're driving through the New Forest, because there are always lots of animals around this time of year. May is a common time for the horses to have their young ones, so be extra careful for this and keep an eye out. So we missed a bit of the road there because I think the GoPro overheated. It's in the window. Just here. And it got really hot, so we may have missed coming through part of the forest and just going to Livington, which is a shame, but we might be going past it on the way back, so hopefully it'll be okay then. Suzanne's driving. You okay, honey?
Yeah.
Max is chilling out in the back, like he always does. We flew past them, but there are some little lambs in this field by this tree that you may or may not see. Welcome to Barton-on-Sea, the first stop off on our New Forest beach tour. Here we are at the seafront in Barton, our first stop of the day. It goes all the way down there.
Look at that.
So we are here at Barton-on-Sea, our first beach for the New Forest. You can see it's Pebbly Beach and the tide is in. Very beautiful, not very busy actually. I thought it was a lot busier than this. So it's pleasant to be here. I'm just gonna take a walk down to the beach now. But first, parking. Let's go and sort out the payment, because there is lots of paying display here. We don't get much free parking in the UK. There's normally a paying display, or we pay on our phones with an app, so it's always going to cost us, but half an hour free would be nice just to get us through a little bit of sightseeing. So let's go for a walk down to Barton Beach. I think I've done something stupid and forgotten the battery charger, so I may run out of battery. Line of beach huts, I imagine they would be pretty expensive to own or rent, particularly the views that they're enjoying. So that hill we walked down at the start, Max unfortunately had a mighty crash coming down it, so it is a quick wash up with salt water from Mummy for him. I like it here, it's a really pretty beach. There's sand, flowers, beach huts, there's a cafe up top which you're going to see in a minute, so yeah, nice place. So that is the first beach done, not without its accidents. We are now going to go back up to the camper van and head to the next beach, so we will see you there. A pretty big hill, Max, you've scooted down. I'm not surprised you fell off, look how steep it is.
Yeah, I think it hit one of these.
Yeah, it should be that one. I think it's that one.
It's a lot harder walking up than walking down, that's for sure. Yeah, it wasn't straight back to the camper van. We thought we would see if we can get a coffee. Well, mainly an ice cream for injured Max. The Beachcomber Cafe is obviously closed because of the dreaded C word, but we were able to wander down the street and get him an ice cream from a newsagent. They must enjoy some nice views on a day like today.
We thought before we went to the next beach we would have a spot of lunch. We have done some toasties in the Ridge Monkey. I'm not sure if I'm pointing that at the right thing. And here is our lunch. Taken up a car parking space, but we've only paid for one. We would have to move if asked, but
we didn't really pay.
Not a bad place for lunch today. This is the result of Max's tumble down the hill on his scooter.
Yeah.
I wonder where he's planning on landing.
Yeah, they make it look so easy. And here comes his buddy. Now, it's time to move on. Narrow roads and tractors in this part of the world. And here we are at Milford-on-Sea, which is where our second beach is of today's little trip. Thank you.
have arrived at Milford-on-Sea. That was only a 10-minute drive from Barton-on-Sea. Different beach this one, it's a bit more shingly and not as big, although it looks like the tide's in. But a bit further along there is beach, which we'll have to find out what that is. That might be Key Haven. But yeah, so we're here, we're going for a walk. First, we have to pay. Let's go and see what the prices are at this one. Another £2 for 20 minutes we're going to be here for, but I guess that's what it is. It'd be nice if they had like half an hour free or something for short stops, but it's not, so it's not worth a ticket, not for £2.
The cafe here is closed, of course, but it's called the Needles Eye Cafe. It overlooks the Needles Rocks, which are on the western tip of the Isle of Wight. The tower that you can see at the end of the Needles is actually a lighthouse, which was fully automated in 1994. The Isle of Wight is definitely on the agenda for another trip when the campsites open up again, so we can explore the island and the Needles in more detail then. So for now, we're looking at it from afar.
So like I said, we are at Milford-on-Sea, which is a nice beach. There's lots of benches for you to sit on, as you can see. Some down there. Max has found the stone, but we have to leave it here because it's for people to look at. Looks like it's a religious thing, talking about Psalm 9.1. This is a very pebbly beach, so if you've got sensitive feet, bring some form of shoe. Big promenades, easy for walking along. Max is having a scoot despite his previous accident. He's got straight back on the horse, which is good. And apparently we are now going to go and see if the toilets are open, because a lot of them are shut because of coronavirus.
And unsurprisingly, the toilets were shut, so we have to wait that little bit longer. So along here there's loads of colourful beach huts, and I'm actually standing on the roof right now. So we are going to head down to the next level down and you'll see all the bright coloured doors, but it's really easy to get up here. There's ramps, so you could take a pushchair or a wheelchair if necessary, but we will head down there now and show you the front of the huts. Not forgetting, of course, that the ramps are also great fun for a 5-year-old and a scooter. Maybe huts was the wrong word. They're not typical beach huts, they're more like little sheds, but there's a sink in them and people enjoy them, I'm sure. So you can just make out in between each door there's pictures in the concrete. You can see a lighthouse in that one, you can just about see. This one you can see like a ship on the water, so it just adds a little bit of texture to it.
So this one certainly has easier access than Barton-on-Sea, as you can imagine. It's got the other ones up the big hill, which is fine going down, but coming up is harder. Here it's a lot It's a lot easier, obviously. So it's good.
It's great here, they have a couple of play parks for the older and younger children, but again closed because of COVID. And some nice houses being built. Great views again, I'm sure. Seeing a lot of these signs everywhere today. This beach is where we are heading next, and the pile of rocks with what looks like a flag but turns out to be a light on is something that we had a climb on when we got there. Some nice houses along this seafront, that's for sure. Some pretty decent views, as I've said already. Nice to live in those. Let's continue to our next beach. So we are not sure if we're in the right place. We're near Key Haven, but we're not sure if it's Key Haven Beach. So we are going to head over the spit over there and have a look. So welcome to Hurst Spit. Over in the distance we can see the Hurst Point Lighthouse and Hurst Castle itself, which we won't make today, but we will save for another time, that's for sure. And somewhere over here is Campervan. There she is. And if I can keep my camera steady, you can see Milford-on-Sea, where we were 20 minutes ago. There's the car park. And a bit further along, you can see the beach hut doors, the bright coloured doors that we were walking in front of just a few minutes ago. Some pretty cool cloud formations here today.
So that is it, we are going to leave.
So if one thing is clear, I need a decent microphone. Basically here I was saying that this is Hurst Spit we're on, and it leads out to Hurst Castle. You can see just behind us the road that we came down. We travelled down here and turned left and parked just over there, and we are now going to head along the coast towards Key Haven and ultimately we're going to end up in Leap is our next stop today, so sorry about the wind. Let's move on. Just realised I'm sticking out a bit, so I'm just going to move the camper van. Let's do that now. So, welcome to Keyhaven. We've stopped off here on the way to Leap. There isn't really a beach here, so Hurst must have been the beach around Keyhaven. We are on this footpath that leads all the way round to Lymington and beyond, so we are going to do that walk one day, but not today. But yeah, the tide's out, as you can see, the skies are blue. Let's go for a little walk at least. I do like the look of this house here. It reminds me of an old American house with a porch and something that happened in the old days. Here's that house again and the views it enjoys. The brick building on the Isle of Wight that you see there is Fort Albert, and the Isle of Wight stretches to the right, and we can see the Needles off in the distance, and if you look closely you can also see people walking along the Hurst Spit where we were 15-20 minutes ago.
It's going to be a walk we're going to do, like I said, I think. But it's a beach, not here. It must have been Hurst.
And one last time before we leave, Hurst Castle next to Hurst Point Lighthouse. Let's head to Leap Beach. And the GoPro stopped again. I've really got to get a new camera. Let's try again. Welcome back to Lymington. We are not going to go through the high streets because traffic can be bad, so we're going to take a little detour around the outside and we will pop out the other side in a minute. a train crossing. And on the right here is where the sea turns into the Lymington River, which, from what I can see from Google Maps, goes as far as Brockenhurst and maybe beyond. So we are about to cross back into the New Forest, so we have to be, there's the cattle grid, we have to be on the lookout for the animals again. You can tell we're approaching Bewley. Well, they don't care, but I'm sure they were here long before we were. Yes, I know I'm showing you a lot of us driving, but here are some more of those little donkeys just wandering down the road. Let's get to Leap. Here we are at one of the Leap Beach car parks, and let's find somewhere to park.
So there is a path along the cliff top here that runs parallel with the sea that we're on now. I'm just going to take a little stroll along here. Mini hike. And show you as it comes out onto the beach at the other end. So there are lots of these little cutouts with little paths that head down to the beach. Go back and carry on walking along the path. So here's the path that I was on. It's another one of these little paths going down to the beach. Let's carry on walking so that we can out. It's just way too windy down here for the microphone on the camera to pick up what I'm saying. So let's just have a walk along the beach and see what we can see. It's a mixture of sand and sort of pebbly shingle, as you can see. A few people down here today, but tide is out, obviously. But a popular place to come, particularly at weekends and in the holidays.
Shingle Beach makes it hard work to walk along, so hard sand. It's a good exercise for you. Just up there, that's where the path runs along that I was on 10 minutes ago. Cut down here, but further up there's little stairs and little alleyways you can cut down, little walkways.
So So we are now back on the lower beachside car park. There are three car parks down here at Leek Beach. You've seen two of them. The third one is further along the west coast, a couple hundred yards. And we're now back at the cafe, which is in the lower car park. So talking about this as I was walking around was pretty impossible. So this is the walk from the beach up to the park where the camper van is. And to our left as we go up, you'll see the play park for the children, which is currently closed thanks to coronavirus. So there's nobody in there today. Thinking of heading this way, this is a great place to set up. There's lots of space up here where you can picnic and play ball games, and you're still just a short walk from the beach down the slope, and the cafe is just there as well.
That is Suzanne.
See you at Cow Shots in after tea. Bye. It is 6:15. We've done four of the six beaches. We spent probably too long at the first two beaches, so we've decided to do the last two another day. So we've been out for 7 or 8 hours, 7 hours already, and we're all getting a bit tired and sunburned and stuff. So we are going to do the next two beaches another day, but they're still going to be coming up. I'm telling you this in case you see me with a raincoat and a jumper on, an umbrella, and no sunglasses. I have got eyes. See you at the next beach. Welcome. It is the 26th of May, a couple of days after our first attempt. We've got two beaches to go, so we are now going to head to Cowshot and Elling, and we will see you there.
So here we are arriving at Cowshot. The first car park is just coming up. It's one-way system, but off to the right there, there is some free parking, but it looks pretty full, so we are just going to head and try and park beachside. So we'll find a spot in a minute. Another beach with lots of brightly coloured beach huts to enjoy in this weather. It's looking pretty busy. Ooh, ice cream man. Let's find that parking space. There's one, a bit tight, but we'll get in there.
Welcome to Cowshot Beach. It's very busy. It's half-term holidays in the UK, so the children are off school, even though they'll be off school anyway. But the parents have probably arranged time off as well, so there's a lot of people here. We are at Cowshot Beach. I don't know if you can hear this. Shingle Beach, quite busy because of the weather. It's beautiful. and we're just going to take a little walk up and down now, maybe as far as Calshot Castle, and we will see what we see.
We have a keen swimmer swimming the Solent.
So Forley and the area that Calshot was in is a little bit industrial. That I think is the Forley, that is a quarry I think, and it's proves the backdrop for the windsurfers. So the city of Southampton is over there, and you can just see the Red Funnel Ferry, which serves the port of Southampton to the Isle of Wight. We've got it once or twice, so it's a convenient trip to take.
This is Anne braving the cold water. She's wussed out. Max, however, he's gone up to his waist nearly. Max is saying he's in the sea and he's not even in his swimming costume. He's got his normal shorts on and his normal t-shirt. Get him wetter and wetter. Give him an inch and he'll take a mile.
We're a Calshot caravan and camping club, where you can pitch up beachside, but you have to be a member. It's obviously shut at the moment because of coronavirus, but we're going to go and check it out because we've applied our email to get on the waiting list to join it. So let's go have a look at that.
So this is the little camping area. So it doesn't take, I don't know how many vans or tents it will take, but it will take a decent number, I would think. Let's see what it says over here. So it looks like we've got chemical toilet waste and somewhere to wash it out, and there's also somebody could do with emptying the bins. So these are the pictures along the seafront. We've got Max standing on the corner of one, and it goes down to here, so they're pretty big pictures overlooking the sea. I can only assume this is where the toilets are and the showers, presumably. It's quite a big shower block, I don't know what is in there, but we will carry on exploring. Calshot Activity Centre. There's a velodrome in there, there's rock climbing, Ringo's, indoor ski slope. Fun for everyone, but of course, as with everything else at the moment, it's closed.
So there are three main hangars here at Calshot. One of them is called the Sunderland Hangar, which is named after a plane called the Short Sunderland. It's a type of plane. The other one is called the Schneider Hangar, which is named after Jacques Schneider, who is a French balloonist and aircraft enthusiast. And the third one in the distance there is the Sopwith hanger, which is a type of bat boat, and I have this information from Wikipedia, so please feel free to challenge me.
Here we have Calshot Castle, the biggest castle in Calshot. It's a teeny tiny castle as castles go. There you go, Calshot Castle.
And it wouldn't be a castle without a moat. Calshot Castle at Calshot Beach. I think it's time to move on.
Here we are, the other side of Calshot Activity Centre.
So that is Calshot Beach. It is now time to move on to the final beach, which is at Ellin, just down the road. Well, about 25 minutes away. Let's go. So here we are at Elling. The bridge ahead of us is a toll bridge, but not charging until the 1st of June, but we're going to find somewhere to park this side of the bridge, and I think to our left looks pretty good, so let's head in there.
At Elling, let's go and have a wander around.
So this is a really pretty little town. We've lived here for 4 years, or near here for 4 years, and this is the first time we've been here, so it looks pretty good.
Old bridge here. We didn't drive across it, so we were okay. So we are in Elling. It's quite nice here, there's not much of a beach, you can see in a minute. But there's a tidal mill, which we're going to look at next, when everything's open again. Yeah, it's really pleasant, especially the weather. We've got the boats, and I'll show you all that now.
So we may have copped out on this one. We didn't really do much exploring. There's this little beach, if you can call it that, here, and over there seems to be another one which we didn't actually go to. It's very pleasant, but I think the other beaches are more beach-like, obviously. But it's a really nice place to sit out, but you can tell that we are on top of Southampton Docks. It's a real pleasant little marina, all these boats. There is a pub here that is not open, but I bet this is a great place to sit out in the sun on a nice Sunday afternoon. And this is the Elling Tide Mill gift shop.
Still a nice little place, nice little harbour, lots of marina, lots of boats, there's a pub down there, so yeah, very pleasant.
And that brings our tour of 5 or 6 New Forest beaches to a close, so thank you for watching. And we will now head home. So again, thank you for watching, and in our next video we have taken delivery of a new bike rack, so we will be showing you how to fit that to the back of a T5 camper van. So don't forget to subscribe and like this video, hit that little bell so you get the notifications, and we will see you next week when we will be at home on the driveway fitting the bike rack. See you then. Thanks for watching.